I can't believe I'm really making this type of video right now. And first off, I'd like to apologize, guys. I'm sorry I have to do this, but I really just have to get it off my chest right now. As someone who has strictly played COD for the past 9 years now, I've never, like, actually thought that COD was in this terrible state right now. No matter how many people went on Twitter or social media and made fun of how COD's dead, how this series is trash, this and that, I was just one of those fans who still enjoyed playing for what the game was, and I never even switched up making content like other YouTubers did. I'm not trying to gas myself up or anything. I'm dead serious though. I'm as loyal as it gets when it comes to playing any Call of Duty game. But for the past few weeks now, actually for the past couple of months now, I've not been enjoying Black Ops 4. When the game first came out, even before that, when I was playing the beta, I really thought BO4 had the potential to become the best Call of Duty to date. And for a while, yeah, it was on pace to reach that huge accomplishment. But recently, the game has made some absolutely horrendous decisions that even I cannot stand behind. It's to the point now in the past 8 years that I've been on YouTube as a COD YouTuber where I seriously do not feel like posting any content on the game right now whatsoever. Like, I'm just not motivated. I don't want to push you guys through watching any videos that where I'm just completely unmotivated to talk about or anything. Like, I just don't have that same passion or desire right now to upload anything regarding BO4 and maybe even Call of Duty related right now. I don't know. But like I said, for the past 8 years now that I've been on YouTube, this is such a new feeling for me, and I absolutely hate this feeling. I do. Inside, it's killing me. Like, every single day that I don't post a video or something comes out on BO4 that I'm not uploading, it's really, like, killing me inside because I just don't care. I really don't. The only saving grace that's keeping me still somewhat actively playing is Blackout Battle Royale and, I guess, a little bit of League play here and there. But that's only if I have a friend on. I cannot make myself play this game solo because it's just simply not fun. In a total, I do have 16 days played on the game, which I guess is a decent amount, but most of the time I've played, it's on blackout. But the point is, I just don't wake up every day or come home from work or class and think, hey, I'm gonna hop on COD, or during my day, I cannot wait to play Call of Duty. Like, that feeling of excitement just is not there anymore. And lately, I've been reminiscing on the past a little bit. And I'm sure you guys remember the days where you would hop on and can always find a team of 5 friends to play with. But now, I'm lucky if there is even a total of 5 players playing BO4 on my friends list. It's that bad compared to my Xbox 360 days. Pretty much my entire friends list would be on Call of Duty. I seriously do miss those days of watching OG YouTubers like Woody's Gamer Tag, Wings of Redemption, Hutch, XJaws, T-Martin, Whiteboy 7th Street, Only Use Me Blade, Optic, Drifter, all of the old Machinima Respawn directors, some of those names you might not have even heard of before, but these were the ones who pioneered COD on YouTube, and now most of them do not even upload COD anymore because they too fell out of love with the series because of how the direction of the game was heading towards. So, in my opinion, I do feel that COD is dead. But in a sense of where the game used to be back like 6+ years ago, those times, yes, they're dead. And the old school fan base will never ever get to relive that same feeling of excitement again. It's just not gonna happen. So again, those times back then, that's what's dead. Call of Duty in itself is not dead. It's actually thriving pretty well. But it's just that feeling of excitement and wanting to play again. That is just dead. And again, it will never ever get to feel that same feeling again. It's hard to pinpoint what exactly was the cause of this, or even if there was a sole cause. It more than likely was a mix of things, like the introduction of microtransactions, the old fan base growing up, or some of the poor decisions that have been made on the development side of the series. For me, what left a bad taste in my mouth was the Shamrock and Owl event, or lack thereof, plus the $30 melee drama and some other stuff that went down recently on BO4. I've also decided to dedicate a good amount of my time on YouTube. Like when I first started, I was 14 years old and now I'm about to turn 22. And during that time, I've missed out on so much, like hanging out with friends and family, some other personal life stuff that I don't want to get into right now. Just because I wanted to stay home and play COD or make a video. Looking back, I do see that I made somewhat of a bad decision because those decisions really did not make me get ahead or get anywhere in life. But at that same time, COD has actually saved my life because when I was a teenager, I made a lot of stupid decisions back then. I was heading down a terrible, terrible path. I really don't like talking about this kind of stuff. I've never really opened up to anybody about this before, but COD has actually been something that has saved me and kept me from, you know, just acting like a fool out there because it kept my mind distracted from a lot of those stupid decisions and things I was out doing. But I don't know, at the same time, I feel that everything does happen for a reason. So I don't regret putting my channel or brand plus COD ahead of everything else in my life. But it did make me realize that, hey, we only do have one life to live. So try to enjoy it as long as possible. Or as much as possible, I guess is the right words to say. If you want to do something or be something really, really bad, just go fucking do it. Go ask that girl out because you may not get another chance to. Go try out for that sports team or band because, again, you may not get another chance to do it. So, like I said, I don't regret anything, but at the same time, it's really opened my eyes to just how to act more professionally and as an adult. So, being on YouTube has definitely also made me become the person that I am today. So I truly am grateful for you guys, for COD and everything else right now. But then lastly, there's just been those decisions made from the higher ups at Activision or the devs at Treyarch that literally made me just sit here and think, what the hell were you thinking by adding this? Or why would they even think this would be a good idea? I don't know, I just felt like making this video just to kind of gauge how y'all may be feeling with the direction of BO4 and the series in general is heading. Please tell me down below in the comments how you feel about COD and how much do you still play, or how often do you still play BO4? Is it like regularly, for a couple of hours a day, once a week, or not even at all? Again, I'm sorry for making this video. I'm sorry for not uploading as much as before. Just know that y'all mean more to me than you will ever know or realize. And I love each and every one of you guys from the bottom of my heart. I'm gonna try and find that same passion as before. Hopefully Modern Warfare 4 or whatever game comes out next will help channel that as well. But again, thank you guys so much for everything. I love you all. Till next time, I'll see you later. One last thing though, I don't want the meaning behind this video to be hating on the devs because we also got to realize that they put in days of work and time into a video game. But there's just been some things that we as fans just simply do not agree with. And as people, as individuals, I don't hate you all. We're all just passionate fans that want the game to be fun and successful, which I know is the same goal you as developers have as well. So if there's any of the devs out there watching this video, I hope you do us proud with your next game. Regroup, come together, and please, please, please keep the fans' interest as the number one priority. And yeah, thank you all for making one of the best series in video game history.